I was late for work on Monday. Tuesday, she never called. Wednesday, I'm here. I work my fingers to the bone. Thursday, worries all around me. Friday, I can barely breathe. I need a cure for the hurt that's ailing me. You can feel no pain when your feet start moving. Just let loose and you feel alright. Just keep it going all night. Their troubles, everybody's been alone. There's nobody here that could make it on their own. When your worries all around you got you bad and you can't sleep, listen baby and I tell you what you need. Can't feel no pain when your feet start moving. Just let loose and you feel alright. Keep it going all night.
The time is finally here, the night you have anxiously been waiting for since you got here. Tonight you pick your society. Tonight you make one of your most important decisions as a student here at Florida College. I could stand up here and tell you why you should join Arte and not join the other societies. But in all honesty, each one of these societies has something to offer each one of you. Over the past few weeks, you've gotten to mingle with the officers on all these societies and learn their names and faces. I stand here to tell you that all of them are of the highest level of integrity and Christ-likeness. And that is true of the people on my officer team as well. Because here on Arte, we pride ourselves in striving for excellence. Philippians 4:8 reads, "Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things." Excellence is something we must work for. And over the past few months, I've been blessed to be a part of an officer group where excelling in Christ is a top priority. These people are some of the most encouraging and fun individuals I have had the pleasure of meeting. These people are my family, and Arte is my family. I can confidently say that if you want to grow in an environment that is spiritual, uplifting, and all around just a good time, Arte is a society for you. As the year goes on, attendance to society meetings and events tends to drop as we gradually get busier. To avoid this, we have planned bi-weekly meetings, monthly community service events, devotions, singings throughout the year. One of the biggest parts of campus life is societies. They allow you to play sports, make friends, and most importantly, grow spiritually. That is why the decision you make tonight is so important. It will play a vital role in your experience here at Florida College. There is something to be said about friendships that you make here. Ask anyone who went here and they will probably tell you that the friends you make during your time at this school will be some of the most important people throughout the rest of the course of your life. Arte will allow you this opportunity to meet new friends and grow closer to old ones. I think I speak for everyone on my officer team when I say that this society has helped give us some of our closest and truest friends. I'm thankful to be a part of this society, and we hope you will join us too for what will be the best year of Arte yet. Thank you.
Thank you. Afternoon, ladies and gents. Welcome back to another episode of Officer Hunter. Today we'll be hunting the elusive Omega Officers. Known to be very determined creatures, they gallop the plains of Temple Terrace in search of others to join the ranks. Let's get started. There's one now. That one's known as a vice president. He can be seen doing things like Bible studies and motivating the others and things like that. I'm going to poke it with a stick.
Hey, Dawson.
He's a tricky one, isn't he? We have the elusive Robin. I've been hunting him for 37 days. His many roles have included... Wait, what? He's not an officer? Here is the Omega President. He is king of all he surveys, and by that, I mean the music theory room from 9:15 to 10 p.m. on Monday nights, subject to change. Seeing as he's the leader of the pack, I'm gonna wrestle him.
Are you tired of being on a society that hasn't won the Society Cup 3 years in a row?
Omega Kai, we got plenty of great stuff. We got lots of Bible studies.
Some fun folks.
Whatever this thing is.
A cool logo. A cool logo that I'm legally not allowed to show you until the end of the video.
We even got this guy. What? Now, are you sure he's not on Omega? Okay. Can I go home now? Regardless!
Join Omega today! Where do I sign up?
We have no idea.
Ladies and gentlemen, I must confess to you, there are few things in this world I genuinely value more than stories. The life experiences that we share with one another are some of my favorite parts of life. And I'll be the first to tell you, Omega Kai has given me the best stories of my life. When I showed up at this school, I was merely a shy, quiet kid with hardly a friend to speak of. And now I stand before you today, a more social person than I ever thought I'd be. And all because of Omega Kai. On Omega Kai, you're free to be exactly who it is that you want to be. If it is competition you seek, then look no further. With an athletic department led by our athletic directors, Ethan Sutherland and Naomi Thompson, you are free to play sports as little or as much as you would like. Outside of sports, it should be noted that Omega Kai has won the Society Cup the last 3 years in a row. That is nothing to sneeze at. Now, besides athletics, it should be noted that Omega Kai has once again a renewed interest in engaging in Bible studies and other devotions. Our Vice President, Caleb Beckley, has doubled down and is more committed than ever to engaging in singings, in Bible studies, and in devotions, and various other things like that, to have more God-centered experiences on Omega than ever before. Omega Chi is truly the place where I have met the most wonderful people I have ever met, I have ever known. Such as our secretary, Tim Malore, our treasurer, Reagan Bingham, our historian, Elena Martin, and our spirit leaders, Dawson White and Maggie Myers. Omega Chi truly is one of the most important parts of my life. It is where I have met my best friends, it is where I have found myself, and it's where I've made my best stories. And truly, that is all I offer you. All I offer you is all that I have. I offer you friends like you will never know. I offer you the funniest people you will ever meet. And most of all, I offer you the stories. The stories that hopefully you will tell your children and their children for years to come.
Harrison Provines, and I'm the president of KO this year. Just wanted to take a couple minutes to introduce y'all to KO and kind of get you to understand kind of what we want to accomplish this year and what we're all about to help you decide if you really want to join KO. So I just want to tell you what KO means to me, why it's so unique to me. And really, honestly, to me, it's just the family aspect. When you join KO, you're KO for life. I mean, you have friends that you get so close when you hang out with each other and all the events that we put on with our society, but also with other societies. We just really have a good time and we really get to know each other. And with KO, I mean, honestly, I just see a unique way where everyone has each other's back. There's really no comparison to KO in that way. We just have such a close family. And for me personally, I can say that our group of officers this year is a very special group of people to me. And we really have a unique bond because it's more than just a group of people that we hang out with. It's really a group of people that we can trust, that I feel like that I can trust, and that all of them have my back no matter what. So if you're debating on which society to join, KO is not for everyone and not every society is for everyone. But if you're debating, maybe this will help you out a little bit. This year we're trying to accomplish bigger things than just for our society. We really want to push for hanging out with all societies and doing a lot of singings, a lot of studies with other societies this year, and really making a special effort to participate in as many joint society events as possible. So if you're really wondering about KO and you're not sure, you know, you've got people trying to convince you one way or the other, I can say this for sure. When you join KO, like if you're not sure, but if you feel a pull to KO, then you know for sure that yes, KO is for you, because KO is not for many. We don't usually have a big group, but if you're really just trying to decide, just always remember that you don't choose KO, but KO chooses you. Roll KO.
Hi, welcome to Zeta 2021. This past summer has been crazy.
With all the craziness going on, Zetans are still hard at work.
We just wanted to share a few moments from this past summer from inside the Zeta headquarters to really give you the inside scoop about what really happens on a daily basis.
So sit back, relax, and enjoy.
We're always looking for ways to create a better viewing experience. So, we started experimenting with a laugh track.
Hi, welcome back to Zeta Weekly Announcements. Here alongside Matt Hume. And I am Kelsey Gillespie.
If it helps to just get one person to laugh at our video, then it's worth it.
Eli,
it's not without its flaws. But I think it gives the view a wider appeal.
I was always just putting others first, and people started calling me Servant Seb. The name stuck ever since.
I like that. Servant Seb.
You have any nicknames around here?
Me? No. People just call me Lexi.
Servant Seb, what is
hey.
Up?
Hey, finger toes.
All right, we're always just messing around.
Yeah.
Hey, finger toes!
I told you that was a secret.
You know, I'll see you around, finger toes.
I think it's coming in good this year.
Yeah, totally.
Then I'm gonna win the mustache competition.
Maybe. Yeah, good luck with that.
You're going down, pal.
See you in 2 weeks.
What's up, Carson?
Hey, what's up, Matt? How you doing, man?
Doing good. Fellas?
With all the responsibilities that Eli was having, it was getting difficult for him to juggle his schedule. So we got him an assistant.
Hey, Mr. President, I need you to sign this for the Vice President of Arte. She wanted it, don't know why. Also, I was thinking this for your mom's birthday.
Perfect.
Pretty cool. Awesome, got it.
We had to get him someone who could anticipate his every need.
All right, knock.
Appreciate it.
Which one?
Right. Your other right.
When you hit that next level, man, there just aren't enough hours in the day.
He'll be with you when he's with you.
Can I see my shorts?
No.
No, I can't. Hey, welcome to Zeta 2021. I'm Zeta's president, Eli Bard. Let's be honest, you probably won't remember much of what I say, or maybe you're not even watching this. Well, that wouldn't really make any sense. But I just want to give you a quick sneak peek on what it's like to be on Zeta this year and the amazing people I get to work with every single day. Normally, I'd introduce you to my wonderful officers, but unfortunately, they're not here with me. But I'll still go through their names. We got Matthew, Matt, Kelsey, Sav, Thomas, Lexi, Sadie, and me, and Carson. Can't forget Carson. Every society has its values. Every society has its goals. I think one of the most important things when choosing a society is how you can grow and how you can help your society grow. In sports, in your spiritual life, in your social life. It's all going to try and be a family. Where do you put your importance? Our theme this year on Zeta is connected. Connected together as a family. Connected together spiritually. Connected together socially and in sports. Now don't get me wrong. We're gonna win a lot of sports games this year. You can bet on that. Specifically, this year, we wanna focus on creating good, strong relationships and an experience that you can remember and that you can value even when you leave this school. Just remember this, not just in regards to societies or FC or anything like this. Remember this in life, that moments last a second, but memories last forever. Hopefully you take this moment to choose to make memories with us on Zeta Phi this year. Thanks.
Whatever happened to predictability? The milkman, the paper boy, evening TV. Did I get delivered here? Somebody tell me, please. This old world confusing me. Clouds as mean as you've ever seen. Ain't a bird who knows your tune. Then a little voice inside you whispers.
Has been wild, to say the least. We started with wildfires, got the measles on campus, almost went to war a few times, experienced COVID for the first time, all got sent home, self-isolated there. People started to wonder about the future of our school year, and then we moved in and we had some fun, and then all of a sudden people got locked away for the safety of the school, myself included. Fortunately, we were all blessed with even just the opportunity to be here, even though the circumstances are as weird as they are. For months, we've been told to distance and spread out, and cover our faces, and to limit human contact. On Psi Beta this year, we had lofty goals that were kind of had to be changed because of these things. But as we learned over the summer, our circumstances will change, and we have to be prepared for that. One goal that we have not had to change, and Lord willing will not have to change, is our theme of unity. I know we aren't allowed to be together, if you will. But we can grow and connect and love even from 6 feet apart. We have decided that this year will not be about us as officers. We will fill our titles and be the face of the society, but it's about you. It's not about us. This year is about making the most of every opportunity. This year is about living for each moment. This year, what we want is to be Beta together. We want to create a culture of love, of support and of unity in this time of hatred, confusion, and isolation. We want to give back to our community by serving the less fortunate through clothing drives and food drives, and then serving whenever we can, as soon as that's possible. We want to grow spiritually and take time in the Word to study and to learn what it means to be a light in this broken world of darkness. There will be some bumps in the road along the way. I know this to be true because of my recently created 2-week plan. I dread not being there to serve you and getting to know you in this very moment. But the society is not me. The society is not my creation, and it's not something that I alone serve. Instead, you are my family. You watch out for me, and I watch out for you, and together we make this society. We have an amazing group of officers this year. I honestly can say that I wouldn't have been happier with any other people helping me out. Cole Gwynn, our male spirit leader, never ceases to bring energy and always gives us his full support. Zach McPherson, our director of societal life, jumped in right away when we needed help and continues to offer his full support and help in every moment and in every day. Danny Applegate, our female athletic director, has worked extremely hard to make sure that our intramural season can even happen. And Robert Miller, our male athletic director, has worked just as hard and done just as much to ensure that we can go off without a hitch. Anna Stringer, our historian, has worked the hardest recently in putting together our amazing video and keeping our social media page active and open to ensure that we have an open level of communication with you, our society. Katie Kintz, our treasurer, has worked continuously to ensure that we have the finances and the money necessary to do the things that we want to do and provide the activities that we want to share with you. Brogan Secreto, our secretary, has worked to keep me organized and to keep our society organized so that our plans and goals are all on track. Jenna Edvinson, our vice president, has been a real trooper through all this. Everything that's happening with me right now and with our society all summer long has been something that she's taken care of right away and without question. And I can't think of anyone that would be better equipped to lead us right now than her. And I'd like to give a special shout out to our female spirit leader, Jordana Volpe, who can't necessarily be with us right now. You may have seen her on some of our missing person posters around campus. And she is unable to join us and she's at home doing online classes. But if you know her, you know the energy and the impact that she has on our society. And so we look forward to her return in January, Lord willing, and greatly appreciate her support through all of this. There's a positive hidden behind every negative, and I hope that you see that we can be that positive.
I mean, oh my goodness. It was so loud, we could hear it from the second floor, but it was at like 1 in the morning. It was just ridiculous.
Good morning, Chloe. Aiden, any messages while I was out?
Just the one from corporate, but I put that in the special filing cabinet.
Great. Oh! Meeting, 5 minutes, conference room.
Is that a ham sandwich? It's a little early for a pub sub, isn't it?
It is never too early for a pub sub, Aiden.
So tonight is a very big night. It is society selection night, and we have to throw the society party. So it is a very big night. I can't mess this one up. Here around at the office, many people consider me a Buddy Payne Jr. or a Buddy Payne the Second. Or a Buddy Payne.
And in-person connection. Connect with people who are coming, and that's all I've got, so.
Thank you, Aiden.
Any questions?
Yes, Clayton.
Have you delegated anyone to security? And if not, can I be it?
No, we have not, but yes, you can.
Yes, okay. Follow-up question. Can I bring a taser?
No, you cannot bring a taser.
Yes, Emily.
So what do we say to people who want to leave Phi Sig for other societies?
We tell them that they will miss our ice cream parties and that they will come back.
Has anyone ever actually come back?
We don't want them back. And they're stupid.
You shouldn't say stupid.
Yes, Natalie?
Is Phi Sig still going to have a good year because of coronavirus?
Absolutely.
How are the boys doing planning the party?
They are doing great, and it will be the best party ever.
Aiden showed us some of the decorations that the boys bought for the party.
It better not be over budget.
Trust me, it is not. Safe to say, the girls will be planning the next party.
Hey, Big Tuna.
No, hey.
How's the party decorations going?
That's going pretty good, Jake.
It's James.
No, I'm not going to call you that.
No, you will call me that.
Okay, Jake. But what I'm saying is, we need to put more balloons on the top so it makes it more like a circle. It'll look a little bit better.
Well, that's going to be determined on how much air our workhorse has left in him.
But what is this?
What's our decorations?
It is society night.
It's the truth. It's a statement of fact.
And what are these? Why are these balloons only 1/8 filled?
Ah, Clayton. Tell them why you only blew the balloons halfway up.
Thought I would save money on jerseys and helium's a fortune these days.
We will be planning the next party.
All right. This year, Phi Sig, we are going to have game nights. We will have Bible studies. We will win sports.
Hey,
we will have singings.
Yeah.
We will have ice cream socials.
Okay.
We will have coffee parties. And we need to get all this and nail it in our society video.
Okay.
Now,
yes.
Who is in charge of that?
Weren't you supposed to hire someone to do that?
Good evening, or good afternoon, or good morning, or whenever you'll be watching this. Usually I'd be performing this speech from the stage and I'd have my officers beside me, so I want to go ahead and introduce them to you since they can't be here right now. Our historian, Natalie Hagwood, our female spirit leader, Emily Selvage, our male spirit leader, James Cook, our female athletic director, Amanda Hagwood, our male athletic director, Aiden Bassett, Treasurer Whitney Eccles, Secretary Chloe Sneed, VP Clayton Slammons, and me, your president, Andrew Hall. This year, on Phi Sigma Chi, all of us officers got together over the summer, and we decided that we wanted the theme to define Phi Sig to be encouragement. The verse that inspired this theme was Hebrews 13, verse 3, and it says, "Encourage and admonish one another daily while it's called today, so you do not be overcome with the deceitfulness of sin." We chose this because we believe right now in the world, encouragement is what everyone needs the most. And while our sphere of influence may be limited to Florida College and the campus, we think that that's exactly what we need right now, is encouragement. So this year on Phi Sig, we want the Phi Sig fam to be a place where if you want to come here and you want to make new friends, you want to meet new people, you can do that. If you want to come, you want to play sports, and you want to win, we'll be doing that. And if you want to come, you want to lead Bible studies, you want to lead singing, you want to grow spiritually, you can do that. And all of it is encompassed in the sphere of encouragement. So anyways, I'll see y'all out there. Have a great year. And remember, choose blue.